today we're working on this new edge Mustang. I've done it before. If you look back through our videos, we did like a before, this will be the after. I'll show you the dyno graph after the modifications. Basically camshaft change, pulley change. It's got a rod and piston bottom end as well now. So a handful of things, but yeah, check it out. Here's this new edge. This thing's really nice. The guy that owns this actually owns a auto detailing place, so naturally his car is very nice. It is a blown two valve. Car made 320 to the tire previously. It's got a smaller pulley on it. It's also got a camshaft change and again a built rod and piston bottom end while they were in there. I got some touch-up stuff, trick full valve covers, some other odds and ends in under there that weren't there before. But again, I can't just tell you how nice this thing is. It's gorgeous. I think they put, I don't remember these seats being in here before, but maybe they were. Yeah, again, just a beautiful car. So I'm going to just dive into this thing, run through the drivability. It's got a base map on it already, which seems to be in the ballpark cruising-wise. So I'm going to run through the math curve of that thing and start making some power hits, see what we can make to the ground. So. Here's the before and after. There's the before, 311, 319, and it made 360, 364 now. So 40 foot-pounds of torque, or I'm sorry, 50 foot-pounds of torque and about 40 horsepower. Here's the differences in the graph. The top two lines there being the current one, the bottom two being the previous setup. So definitely made some power gains. I'm gonna say the majority of that is from the pulley change. Obviously the cams helped a little bit, but you gotta keep in mind with a blower car, the supercharger is the primary air pump. We're not going to make more horsepower than what the supercharger can flow. And the camshaft just help us take the best advantage of what the blower can move, right? So we were running into some intake air temp issues. Nothing too serious. At the end of a fourth gear hit, it was 152 degrees. But I feel like that's about the max I want to go on pump gas. This thing's still on 93 octane. So the tune's relatively safe. I think with a better intercooler or a more efficient supercharger at the same boost level, we would be able to make a bit more power, obviously cool the air down, and then be able to turn the boost up yet further. Yes, it's making 8 or 9 pounds now, but that's it for this thing. I'm going to get it off of here and work on the next project, see if we can upgrade this thing and see it again down the road.